Greetings friends, are you someone longing for a spark of inspiration and motivation to trigger your inner flame and unleash your maximum potential? Please listen to the following story carefully. Wilma Rudolph was born in the South American state of Tennessee. At the age of 5, Wilma was diagnosed with double pneumonia and scarlet fever. The doctors predicted that Wilma will not be able to walk throughout the course of her life, and they fitted a brace on her legs. But Wilma's mother kept on encouraging her by feeding her with positive thoughts. She made Wilma understand the power of God-given ability and persistence, along with a strong determination and willpower. At the age of 9, Wilma wanted to become the fastest woman on the earth. She tried hard, and going against the doctor's advice, Wilma removed the brace off her legs and started walking, and initially practiced running also. At the age of 13, Wilma entered the Tennessee University for a sports meet. She participated in a running race and ended up way, way last. She was not a winner for almost 1,000 races. Again and again she failed, and eventually she was able to ace the winner position in a running race. Following all this, Wilma Rudolph met a person called Ed Temple, and Ed Temple turned to be the coach of Wilma Rudolph. Under the guidance and leadership of coach Ed Temple, Wilma improved her capabilities when it comes to professional running. Wilma participated in the 1960 Olympics. Ed Temple, the coach of Wilma Rudolph, called her and advised that Olympics is a professional platform and you would be matched with the finest athletes of the world. And the then world champion of women athletics was Jutta Hain. And Wilma Rudolph was on the track competing with Jutta Hain. There were totally 3 events for women that year. The first race was 100 meters dash. Wilma Rudolph competed with the then world champion Jutta Hain and aced the championship. Wilma won the 100 meters race. The next one was a 200 meters dash, and Wilma Rudolph once again competed with Jutta Hain and aced the winner position. And the last one was the 400 meters relay. Generally, in the 400 meters relay, the most capable athletes finish the track for their team. That is, they run at the last 100 meters dash. The team members done a great job, and they gave the baton to Wilma Rudolph and Jutta Hain. While it was their turn to run, Jutta Hain picked up a thunderbolt speed and she was raging towards the finish line. But Wilma Rudolph unfortunately dropped her baton. She took her baton, picked it up, and with all the courage she speeded up towards Jutta Hain and raced her, and eventually completed the 400 meters relay also with the winner position. My dear friends, this incident became historic, and that is the greatest speciality of the 1960 Olympics. As Wilma Rudolph dreamt as a 9-year-old girl, she became and was officially declared as the fastest woman on earth, having won the 100 meters dash, 200 meters dash, and the 400 meters relay of the 1960 Olympics. Isn't that amazing, friends? In spite of all the natural or innate incapabilities that a human possesses, it is one's willpower and determination that makes someone great in life. Please have courageous determination and always focus on positivity. Let the negative naysayers tell whatever they want. Just ignore and focus on your mental courage and keep working on your goals. Success is definitely yours. Thank you so much.